Hi guys, I'm Dr. Tara Tobias. I want to welcome you all back to this channel. In today's home exercise tutorial, we're going to be going over a couple of ideas or concepts that have been coming up in the comments that I think are important to clarify. And it's going to involve probably the most popular problem that many of you are trying to resolve, and that is walking or some walking problems. I know I've done a ton of exercises on walking. This video is going to include some exercises on walking. Primarily for those of you that either think you have spasticity in the leg or a severely stiff leg. So I've done a lot of videos on spasticity, but there are some of you that still say like you can't do any of the exercises that I've shown in many of the videos on spasticity. So I'm going to kind of group you guys into a category of severe leg spasticity and go over a couple of ideas that I haven't shown in other videos for exercises that might be better suited for you and where you're at in the recovery process. Also, anyone who thinks they are vaulting, so I've done a whole video on that. I'll put a link for that in the description below. Or anyone who cannot bend their knee when they try and swing it through, which might result in circumduction, which has come up a couple of times in the comments, and I really haven't done a whole video dedicated to that, but any of you that think you swing your leg around the side or cannot bend the leg to bring it through, this video is for you. But before we dive into that, if you're new to this channel and you haven't yet subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, turn on that notification bell so that you'll be notified every time I upload new videos. And now let's go ahead and dive in. So, what causes a leg to feel severe stiffness or to cause the leg to lock out straight and not bend? That is spasticity in the quads. The quads straighten the knee. As I've talked about in several of the videos, spasticity is an involuntary muscle contraction. And in severe cases, so spasticity is rated on a 0 to 4 scale, 4 being the most severe. And in severe cases, it takes a lot of force to bend that joint or to get that muscle to break or release to bend that leg. So in severe cases of spasticity, it is extremely hard to bend the knee. Now, this, if you have severe spasticity in your quads, the muscles that straighten the knee out, you most likely have severe spasticity in most cases in the muscles that point the foot. They are usually joined together. So if you have severe spasticity in one, you usually have it in the other. So if you have that, then your foot also points really hard. And a lot of times you cannot flex the foot up, and in cases where your stroke was a long time ago, now you have contractures, so the foot just stays pointed. But we're not going to get into that. So the only reason I bring that up is because some of these exercises might not work because you actually have a contracture, meaning the muscle has shortened and will not lengthen to allow your foot to come up. So just keep that in mind, that some of you, even as hard as you might try, your foot is still going to stay pointed until you get that muscle lengthened. So all that being said, how do you bend the knee if you are in this category of severe spasticity and you cannot bend your knee? Now, I've done a video on knee hyperextension because they usually go hand in hand. And in that video, I showed a number of exercises to bend the knee, and I'll put a link for that video in the description below. But also on Instagram recently, I also showed a couple of exercises to break up that spastic pattern or that abnormal synergy pattern. And there were some of you that said that you just cannot bend your knee. So what do you do if you cannot lay on your stomach and bend your knee, which, as I've mentioned on Instagram, is my go-to. That is the ideal position to work on bending the knee. But what do you do if you can't do that in that position? Next would be to go to that video on knee hyperextension. Video in the description below. And then if you still can't bend the knee, today I'm going to show you the next best option. And that is to get in a gravity assisted position. But what we're going to do is we're just going to use gravity to bend the knee. So I highly recommend a mat table. If any of you have had stroke, this is going to be a long journey. I think a mat table is extremely valuable and is a worthwhile investment for your exercises. So I prefer that this be done on a mat versus a bed, but you're just gonna lay back, and even if your leg is stiff straight out, you're just gonna lay there and allow gravity to bend the knee. Now, if that doesn't work, I recommend you get some ankle weights. In this case, the weight's not to add resistance, it's to actually help gravity to get that quadricep muscle to relax to allow the knee to bend. So if you can see what we're doing here, it is not about an active movement. And I think a lot of you think that you need to actively work to bend the knee. Step one, which is kind of in that passive range of motion category that I talked about when I went through the stages of how you progress exercises, that first stage is passive. So you should not be thinking active commands. You should be thinking relax. You're in that passive stage. You're probably going to be here for a while, probably a couple of weeks. That is okay. But you're basically just going to try and learn how to get that quadricep muscle, the knee, the muscle that straightens the knee, to relax. Once you can do that with the weight on, take the weight off, and again, try and get that knee to bend. Now, the next step, and this is problematic even for those of you that can occasionally unlock the knee, this next one is for you. Now, what you're going to do is you're going to straighten the knee and then try and get it to relax. Once you actively command that quadricep to work, that makes it doubly hard a lot of times to get that quadricep to relax. So basically, now you're going to do what we call like reversals. So you're going to contract and then get it to relax. So you're gonna contract and then get it to relax. Those reversals, that's extremely hard in the stroke recovery process to go from contracting a muscle to immediately relaxing it. But if you think about it, that is walking. You're standing on the leg, everything's contracted. In order to bring that leg through, you need everything to relax. And so then that gets into what you need to think about when you're walking. So get really good at that, contract, and then letting it relax. On your back, on the bed. Once you get really good at that, when you walk, to carry this over into walking, what you want to think about, everyone is so eager to bring that leg through. Again, you're thinking active commands. You really want to think relax. During the walking cycle, right before you swing the leg through, from contracting all the muscles, that contract phase when you're standing on it, before you swing it through, there is a moment in there where the leg is more or less completely relaxed. And most people skip over that, or they can't relax, so they just swing the leg around the side or vault or hike their hip up to get that leg through. But there is a moment there where you need to relax. So when you're practicing your walking in a controlled environment, preferably with very little stimuli, so my suggestion would be to practice this in your home and just walk up and down a hallway, but really focus on that relax moment before you swing the leg through. So I've shown stuff with your leg on a skateboard to work on swing, things to let it slide. Most of those are passive. If your leg is completely relaxed, if you just shift your weight a little bit and there's something with wheels underneath your foot, your leg is just gonna automatically come forward. You do not need to be telling your leg an active command at that point. So that is a big mistake that most people make, and I'm going to make another video on this because some of you have asked about Trendelenburg, and that is one of the problems with Trendelenburg as well, and many don't catch that. Even a lot of therapists don't catch that. So I'm gonna go over that in a video coming up here after this one. I don't know if it'll be next week, but in the next couple weeks. But you need to work on that relax command to swing that leg through. So again, this video is for those of you that either have severe spasticity and you cannot bend your knee on your own command, or those of you that maybe you're getting better at it laying down, but as soon as you get up to walk, you feel that stiff leg come back. Then this is what I would focus on when you're working on your walking, is that relax moment right before you swing the leg through. So in addition to that, there's one other thing I want to go over that's come up in the comments, and I don't know if you guys saw my Instagram post a couple weeks ago, but someone had commented on a video that she had done one of my stretching or passive range of motion exercises so many times that the passive movement became active. And I thought it was such an excellent comment to drive home the point that I make in a lot of these videos, is that it's not doing 3 sets of 10. There is no magic number. And that is probably the number one comment I get. How many times should I do this a day? You do it until you get it, until your brain gets it. It's the same thing you would do with athletes in sports. You don't most of the time give an athlete a number, go do that 10 times. Sometimes you do because you're trying to stick to a schedule. But if you really want to perfect something, you do it until you get it. There is no magic number. If I said 10 and you moved on, then that would be counterproductive because you haven't mastered it yet. But you do it until you get it. That person did the exercise so many times that the passive movement became active. So it works if you are patient and you stick with it. Do not skip over these passive exercises. You do it until it becomes active. And you don't try and add resistance until you can do it consistently, actively, without resistance. So that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and leave your comments below. Honestly, you guys are getting so good in the comments. Like, some of you that have been commenting for a while, now you just automatically chime in with how you applied that video or how you do it different from what I suggest in the video, which I think is amazing. So keep doing that, because I promise you, for those of you that are watching this video, there is more answers to your questions in the comments than there probably is in this video. So definitely thank you to all of you that keep leaving comments and you leave encouraging comments to other people. I love it. Keep that coming. Again, if you haven't yet subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Turn on that notification bell so that you'll be notified every time I upload new videos. If you like this video, again, give it a thumbs up. Again, that is it for today. I will see you all in the next video.